Привіт-привіт, my dear friends. My name is Inna and welcome to my YouTube channel Speak Ukrainian. Today we'll have a little bit history lesson and I'm going to teach you the meaning of the word москаль. But before we start, I would like to ask you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video and leave your comments about it. So, поїхали! Let's get it started. I'm sure you heard this word from Ukrainians, maybe from the social media or from our news, and I wanted to explain you the meaning of the word. Actually, we call Russian people this way, not only orcs, and let me tell you more about it. Москаль, also known as москаль, is a historical designation used for the residents of the Grand Duchy of Moscow from the 12th to the 15th century. Initially, as early as the 12th century, москаль referred to the residents of Московія, the word literally translating as московіте. So, as you know, maybe you haven't heard it before, but Russia was called as Московія many centuries ago. So they had this kind of name, and then on the 2nd of November in 1721, so this is the 18th century, Russian Tsar Peter I decided to change the name from Московія into Russia, Russia. And Russia, have you ever heard something similar? Ah, yes, Kievan Rus. Aha. So, in Russians, they like to steal a lot of things from us. You heard that they stole like toilets, washing machines, etc. From our cities during this full-scale war. But they also tend to steal our history, our names, our poets, etc. So they stole the name of our Kievan Rus. Kievan Rus, this is our ancient state, and it was founded in the 8th century and it lasted till the 13th century. And in the 18th century, Russian Tsar decided to change the name from the Московія into the Росія. So they took this name from the Rus, and therefore this Tsar decided to connect Russia to the European cultural countries. Yes, so yes, but as we can see, they failed to be the modern democratic free country. And I'm sure maybe you heard this or you saw this picture, Kiev and Moscow. Please check it out. And this is the true facts, how Kiev looked in the 10th and 11th and 12th century, and how Moscow looked at that time. So very interesting fact, but that's true. So they took this name from Kievan Rus. And the negative connotation, however, came in around the late 18th, early 19th centuries in the form of an ethnic slur labeling all Russians. At that time, soldiers of the Imperial Russian Army and later those of the Soviet Army stationed in parts of the present-day Poland, Romania and Ukraine became known as Москалі. So there are many poems and songs in Ukrainian where you can hear about москаль or москалі. So currently this word has a negative name for Russians, how we call them. Okay, and maybe you know our father of Ukrainian language, our great poet Taras Shevchenko, in 1838, he wrote a beautiful poem, Katerina, and here are some lines from this amazing poem. Кохайтеся, чорнобриві, та не з москалями, бо москалі – чужі люди, роблять лихо з вами. Москаль любить жартуючи, москаль жартуючи кине, піде в свою московщину, а дівчина гине. О, lovely maidens, fall in love, but not with Moscovites. For Moscovites are foreign folk, they do not treat you right. A Moscovite will love for sport and laughing go away. He will go back to his Moscow land and leave the maid a prey to grief and shame. So this poem was reading on the true story. Ekaterina, a girl who fell in love with this Moscow guy, she fell in love with him, got pregnant, and he left her, and it was a big shame in the 19th century to be pregnant from a man and you are not married, and everybody called her son bastard, and she couldn't live with that, so she made a suicide. So therefore Shevchenko, he wrote the message for all women of Ukraine: do not make love with Moscow guys, like Moscow guys, because they are very bad, they are bastards. Okay, and there is another poem by Jan Taksur. It's called Mirage, and it was written in 1995. Let me read it. Отак подивишся здаля на москаля, і ніби справді він людина, іде собі, мов сиротина, очима блим, губами плям, і десь трапляється хвилина, його буває майже жаль, а ближче підійдеш – москаль. Okay, this poem doesn't have the translation, but I will just give you literal, approximately translation. So it is written like this. So you can look at it far away and see the Москаль, and you may think, oh, he's a real person, it looks so misery, it looks like an orphan, eyes blemish, lips stains, and you feel sorry for him. But then when you come closer to him, you see, that's Москаль, you can nothing do with him. Тьфу, Москаль. Okay, So this is how we call Russians. We don't like them, and we have a tough history with them, and also we call them katsapy. This is another way how we call Russian people, and katsapy is a derogatory colloquial name of Russians, used mostly by Ukrainians as well as Poles or people from Belarus, also the Russian name of some Russian sub-ethnic groups. So we call them moskali and katsapy. Of course, they have some names for us, how they call us. For example, they call us хохли. What is the origin of this word? Хохол, this is, if you remember how the Cossacks look like. So Cossack men, they are usually bald, and they have this хохол. I don't know how to call it. Yes, you can see the picture. So this hair style, it is called like хохол, and therefore they call us хохли. But I don't know, it's not offensive for me, because it was brought from the Kazakhs, and I'm a Kazakh girl. I have this blood. Okay, and they call us Ukry, because from Ukrainci, Ukrainians. But we are a strong nation and we prove it to the whole world. But you are Moskali and Kacapi, you are very misery, you are orcs, so there is nothing to do with you. So, guys, what do you think about this history lesson? Did you like it? Did you enjoy it? So, orcs, don't watch this video. I will block you anyway. Don't leave your ugly negative comments. And guys, if you want to learn more about Ukrainian language, about Ukrainian culture, history, you can sign up for our one-on-one lessons. The trial lesson costs only $1. And if you a beginner in Ukrainian language and you don't know where to start, I want to invite you to my course From Absolute Beginner to a Confident Speaker. The sixth edition of my course will be launched on August 22, but you have to sign up for it now. So all information about my school Speak Ukrainian, about the textbooks, flashcards, courses, blog, everything that I recommend for learning Ukrainian, you can check out all the information or links to description of this video. Please subscribe to my Instagram account Speak Ukrainian Language, support me on Patreon, support my charity project, buy a t-shirt Save Ukrainian Life. Побачимось скоро, see you soon, your teacher Ina, and Slava Ukraini!